Which are good fats to eat and cook with, and which ones are to avoid? That is the question of the day. Hello, this is Aishan, aka the Omnivorist. I'm a nutritional therapy practitioner in Paris, France, and I'm passionate about helping busy moms recover their energy and vitality through real food and healthy habits. And welcome to my series, Ask the Omnivorist, where I answer your burning questions about health and nutrition every Friday morning. Now, fats and oils are one area of nutrition where that nutrition confusion that I like to talk about is very much alive and well. When I see people, especially women, on a diet, avoiding fat in their diets, like whether it be having too much butter or the fat on their lamb chops or their fish skin, it really makes me want to cringe. Because believe it or not, fats are an absolutely essential nutrient. Now, first, let's define a little bit what we're talking about here. Fats are one of the three macronutrients, along with carbohydrates and protein. And like the other macronutrients, they are absolutely crucial to our health and well-being. Okay, but of course, it's especially when we're talking about good fats, including plentiful good fats in your diet, is really, really essential. But of course, it's this idea of good versus bad fats that gets a lot of people confused. So today I'm going to try to shed a little bit light on that. So biochemically, there are three types of fatty acids according to their structure. So there is saturated, monounsaturated, and polyunsaturated fatty acids. Okay. And just so you know, actually, the science, the biochemistry of fats and fatty acids, it's really complicated, but I'm really going to try to simplify it as much as possible. And there is actually no such thing as a pure fatty acid. So there's never going to be like 100% saturated fatty acid, but it's just, let's just say the bigger component in its composition is going to give it its name. So when we talk about saturated fats, these are solid at room temperature, and these are very, very stable. So we're talking things like coconut oil, red palm oil, butter, cream, and many other animal fats. They are in this category. A monounsaturated fatty acid is liquid at room temperature. So we're talking things like olive oil, avocado oil, and sesame oil. And then finally, there are the polyunsaturated fatty acids, or PUFAs, that occur naturally in certain foods like fatty fish, nuts, and seeds. But the problem here is that these days there's a whole slew of industrial vegetable oils like sunflower oil, canola oil, which is colza in French, corn, soybean, etc. Now, these oils are liquid at room temperature, they are highly unstable, and prone to damage from elements like light, heat, and oxygen. Now, so great oils and fats to cook with are, number one, olive oil, which, you know, contrary to what some say, is totally fine to cook with. And if you stick to my dictum about eating real food that your great-grandmother would have recognized, of course, it makes so much sense to be cooking with olive oil, especially for those like me. I'm from a Mediterranean culture. And other good things to cook with include butter, ghee, which is clarified butter that is very common in Indian cooking, for example, coconut oil, and also animal fats, okay? Don't be afraid of all the animal fats. These are traditional, actually, really traditional fats. We've been consuming them for a very long time, and most of them are really stable, so really great to cook with. As long as you can find them from good quality sources, like lard from pastured pigs, also duck and goose fat. Those are especially great to roast root vegetables, for example. And I also want to say a word about red palm oil. Now, the problem with palm oil is its production and its impact on the earth, okay? And that is definitely not something to take lightly. If you can find sustainably produced red palm oil, just know that that is actually really beneficial for health. That has a really interesting nutrient profile as well. Although it has a really strong taste, so I find that it works best with, you know, if you're going to make something really spicy or just something with like a curry mix or something, then it goes really well. So let's also talk a little bit about the bad fats. Now, earlier I told you about PUFAs, okay? Now, please, whatever you do, avoid including those industrial vegetable oils in your diet, okay? Once again, if we take that our traditional real food perspective, these oils have actually not been around for a very long time, and they are the product of industrial food production. And sadly, they have been replacing traditional fats all over the world. And the really horrible irony about that is that they were touted for decades as being heart healthy. And as I said earlier, these oils are really unstable. And what that means is they are highly inflammatory to our bodies. And low-level inflammation has been linked to all kinds of modern diseases, from, of course, heart disease to cancer and diabetes and autoimmune disease, to name a few. So, and the problem is because they are so cheap nowadays and so plentiful, they are really everywhere and in all kinds of processed foods and restaurant dishes. So this is actually an important reason to be avoiding all kinds of processed packaged foods, and checking those ingredient labels really carefully, even at the organic store, and also to avoid restaurant chains. So yeah, you really never know where they're going to show up. And of course, again, if you look at the real food perspective, those oils are usually they naturally occur in real foods, like I said earlier, like cold water fish, nuts and seeds. And when you consume them in that real food package, of course, they are much less likely to go bad, to be inflammatory. Okay. So the bottom line for you today is favor the good fats in your diet. And if your grandma or someone else's grandma cooked with it, go for it. And in that case, definitely don't be afraid of how much you're having. Within reason, of course, having a whole bunch of added fat in your morning coffee may not necessarily be such a great idea, because hashtag real food. Also, the other thing I want to leave you today with is to avoid bad fats like the plague, because there is really no such thing as moderation when it comes to those. Okay? So that's what I have for you today. I really hope that this has been useful and you have a clearer idea now of what to buy the next time you're doing your grocery shopping. And if you would like to find out more about doing this work of nutritional therapy on a and also lifestyle change on a deeper and more personalized level, know that I do work with a small number of one-on-one clients. And if you'd like to find out more about that, we can jump on a free discovery call and see if this might be a good fit for you. Just drop me a line at contact@theomnivorous.com and we can go about scheduling one of those. Also, I just wanted to let you know that next Friday morning is going to be the last episode of this current season of Ask the Omnivorous. And after that, I'm going to be taking a break for the summer. Now you have a wonderful day and I will see you right here next time.